Oh, it started. I didn't realize it.
So do your good werewolves, do they still have the ability to turn humans? If a scratch from one of these werewolves can turn a human into a good werewolf, yes, then why don't you use the good werewolves to create a great army of good werewolves to battle the bad werewolves? You don't know what happens to a werewolf when they create a new werewolf, do you know? It is like the werewolf's soul is being torn apart. Half of the soul goes to the new wolf and half stays with the old one. At least that is how they speak of it. They are not like vampires, they believe that they still have souls. We know better. We still have souls. Piped up Mia. No child, that is one of the first things the hunger steals from you. Not until you completely surrender to the hunger and begin to feast with abandon, will you realize this truth. Like wisdom falling upon deaf ears, the old woman could see what they did not. Thank you, said Mia. Yes, said Ava, thank you for all your help. Mary could see that the two of them were already looking elsewhere and feeling the call of the night. And the beating drums of the drums. She had been there and done that. But with these two, there was no guile or killer instinct. For them it was all fun and games. It wasn't the hunt at all. It was the dance that called to them. Thinking that these were two very strange vampires indeed. She decided right there and then to help them, against her better judgment. Because unless she did so, they were going to get themselves into a lot of trouble. Real quick, so she said to them, have you had any dreams yet? Since you became vampires? No, now that you mention it. Said Ava, I have had the sleep of the dead. Lately, yeah, me too. Well, since I was turned, I have had dreams of past lives that were not my own. And in these dreams I was a great military leader. My army of vampires with their werewolves, werepanthers, battle falcons, and other children of the wereforest had ventured out from our stronghold deep within the enchanted wereforest to drive the humans who were encroaching upon our lands in the enchanted wereforest from them. So our armies and allies, all still loyal to the vampires, to their gods who had led them out of the wereforest, attacked the humans and won victory after victory as we drove them from our lands. But when it came time for us to return to the enchanted wereforest where we were gods, that is when we discovered that there was no way home and we had become trapped here, and were now the hunted, with no way to get home. No escape. So now life became about survival until a way home could be found. Like water, ice, snow, rain, children of the wereforest can take many forms while still remaining what they are. It was as if the vampires, werewolves, and other children of the wereforest, having left the enchanted forest, had became stranded here and forced to take on human form to survive. These dreams have stayed with me all these years, and I feel for all of the vampires as well as the children of the enchanted forest who followed them out of the enchanted forest. Imagine them with no way home, a laughable thought, if there ever was one, but nevertheless true. We were trapped here with no way home without the protections of the enchanted wereforest. Some were quicker to realize it than others, and either abandoned or turned on the vampires, who were as lost as they were, and who they bombed for being lost. From the moment we had stepped out of the enchanted wereforest, the vampire armies and their were allies were trapped here and forced to survive, as best they could, as they searched for a way home. And vampires, gods of the enchanted forest, became the hunted, feared throughout the old world. Then over the years, the great vampire armies, with their werewolves and battle falcons, trapped in this world, would battle each other for glory. Humans were merely our food and not a real threat. Or simply out of boredom with nothing else or to do. Till the bad.